not adequate to the complexity of your data. But essentially, their way of allowing a data set to project for emergent properties that you would not have been aware of otherwise. Are you aware of any data mining techniques that would allow you to discover correlations, especially multifactorial ones, that the human eye would not likely be able to perceive or even think of?
There's a wonderful book by Mark Mormonier called How to Lie with Maps. And I had a spiel in here, a paragraph or two, on isn't it great that we can lie, but now we can lie in diverse ways. One of the problems with any kind of graphic representation is unwitting, it always misrepresents in order to convey significance. GIS is great because you can have multiple modes of representation, but unwittingly, right, the choices we make hide possible significances. And so one of the questions I think you're asking, and it seems to me that's implicit in what you're saying, is are there guaranteed ways of drawing out all possible significances in the data? And I'm not sure what the answer to that is, except if we have multiple ways, at least that we can manipulate, we're likely to see more. Better than a printed map with getting somebody else's view of things, and only that. There's another question which has come up, and we're actually, I also run something at Harvard called the Center for Geographic Analysis. And we're working with social scientists and social science data sets, quantitative data sets, to figure out how to run social science data sets through a gazetteer and output maps at the other end automatically. And there are lots and lots of data sets in social sciences, enormous numbers, and they've been subject to lots of statistical analysis. But they haven't been mapped. They're not spatially enabled. And so one of the things we would like to do in the next 2 years is to create algorithms for spatially enabling social science data sets so that if you look, for example, at a survey, you can see part of the distribution down to census tracts, for example. You can really actually start to see the spatial relationships there. I think that once that happens, then the spatial qualities of stuff in the social sciences is going to become more and more apparent. To some extent, they've already noticed this. I mean, one of the standard ways in which we look at what happens to the American population is by race and class. And it turns out that race and class variables are less predictive than spatial variables for public health problems. So